हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सावित्री नागरा, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स डिपार्टमेंट, जैन पॉलिटेक्निक, बेलगामी। टुडे सेशन वी विल स्टडी यूनिट 4, डेवलपमेंट ऑफ कंट्रोल सर्किट। कंटेंट्स: इंट्रोडक्शन, लैडर डायग्राम्स, स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व्ड इन डेवलपिंग अ लैडर डायग्राम्स, डेवलपमेंट ऑफ कंट्रोल सर्किट्स। इंट्रोडक्शन: फर्स्ट विल नो व्हाट इज मीन बाय डायग्राम्स। Electrical symbols, words and line diagrams provide the information necessary to understand the operation of motor control circuit. There are three general types of control diagrams in use. First one is wiring diagram, line or ladder diagram, wireless connection diagram. What is meant by wiring diagram? This diagram refers to making the initial connections when a control system is first wired. It is used to trace the actual wiring when troubleshooting. And now we'll study what is meant by line diagram or ladder diagram. This is the most easiest diagram to understand the control circuit electrically. In this circuit diagram, showing only elements and connections essential for understanding the principle of operation of the given equipment or its parts. Now we'll know what is meant by wireless connection diagram. This diagram eliminates confusion connection between when many wires must be shown. It is similar to front view of the control panel board indicated with reference numbers and letters. Now we'll move on to ladder diagrams. Ladder diagrams are also called line diagram or elementary diagrams. They are used to represent the function of the control circuit and associated devices. It's very easiest way to understand the connection of control system. This is the diagram of ladder diagram. Now we'll move steps involved in developing a ladder diagram. To draw ladder diagram, first step to draw two vertical lines, one on each side. Second one is the number the wires of the control circuit. Start where the control wire leaves L1 and the number each end of the each wire. Change numbers each time you start another wire until you reach L2 or the end of the control circuit. Third one is, now draw a short horizontal line to the right from L1. Fourth one is, to read ladder diagram, start at the left hand side of the top line and proceed to the right. These all the steps we need to follow while drawing the ladder diagram. First one is, we'll study develop control circuit from one location. From one location, we are developing the control circuit. See, from this here, two vertical lines L1 and L2, and from point 1 to stop push button, start push button, auxiliary contact, motor and overload relays. For each and every line we are starting, we are giving a number, and this auxiliary winding which holds the contacts. Now how it will run, we'll study. First we need to press start push button, motor starts running, and press stop put button, motor stops. When the start push button is pressed, the power flow takes place from L1 to L2. So coil energized and motor will run when the coil is energized. Auxiliary contact will close the current flow through this auxiliary contact. Even if the start button is released, therefore the motor continues to run with the help of auxiliary contact. When stop button press, the motor stops. This is how the one location ladder diagram works. Second one is, develop control circuit from different location. Means there are two locations we are going to control the circuit. It consists of stop button, two top button P1, P2, P3, start button P4, start button, auxiliary contact and motor. When push button P3 and P4 is pressed, the current will flow from line to the neutral and the coil gets energized, so the motor starts running. After coil is energized, holding contact will close and current flows. The running motor can be stopped by pushing off push button P1 and P2. When any push button is pressed, coil is de-energized so that main contact gets open and motor stops. Next one is push button interlocking. To interconnect the motor circuit in a such a way in which the second motor will now start until the first one run, likewise the third one motor will not run unless the second one run, and so on. This kind of motor circuit called interlocking. See here, there are two push buttons, forward push button and reverse push button. It is the method of preventing two contacts being energized simultaneously. Through the contactor A, the motor is fed with a three-phase supply for forward rotation, whereas through contactor B, the motor is fed for reverse direction of rotation. Both NO and NC contacts of the forward and reverse push buttons have been used. When the forward push button is pressed, contactor A gets energized by getting supply through the NC contact of reverse push button. The contactor remains energized even when the pressure on the push button is withdrawn, as no contact of contactor A is now closed. When the reverse push button is pressed, the contactor A gets de-energized first, and then the contactor B gets energized. This ensures that it is not possible to energize both the contractors simultaneously. How it is working, we got to know. Automatic star delta starter for three-phase induction motor. In an automatic star delta starter, delay is obtained by using a timer. The time delay can be adjusted by rotating the dial screw on the timer. The time setting is around 10 seconds for lightly loaded motors. For fully loaded motors, the time setting is more than 10 seconds. When the start push button is pressed, the star contactor coil S and the main contactor coil and the timer coil gets energized. The motor runs in star and the connection continues till timer operates after a preset time 10 seconds. When the motor picks up its normal speed, saying in 10 seconds, the time delay contact will get open and de-energized the star. Delta coil gets energized and the motor runs in delta. For interlocking between two contactor S and D, two NC contacts are connected in series with S and D as shown in the figure. Three-phase motor control. Here, this is a diagram of three-phase motor control. This circuit is to control a three-speed motor. It consists of three simple start circuits, one circuit for each, so that the operator can start the motor in any desired speed. To increase speed, the operator need only to press the button for the desired higher speed. The speed of the motors will be increased by pressing each push button. When the start push button is pressed, the motor M1 will be running through NC, M2 and M3 with speed 1. If PV2 is pressed, the motor M2 will get energized. The motor will run with the speed 2 by making NC, M3 contact to NO. To increase the motor speed from first to second, the normally closed interlock contact identified as M3 will be closed and the coil M2 will be energized. This will break the normally closed contact identified as M2. thus dropping out coil M1 and de-energize the conductor for speed 1. Like this, three-phase motor control works.